everybody. I am the Mademoiselle and this is my channel. And today we are going to be doing a reaction to a Mari episode. Now, let me just say, I have not watched Mari in years, like literally years. I'm shocked that show is actually still on air. And the name of this episode is I Get Good Grades and I Do Whatever I Want. Now, honestly, you guys sent this to me in my Discord. If you guys are not part of the Discord, make sure you guys join the Discord. There are numerous group chats on there and you guys can send video suggestions on there. I'm also looking for new moderators, so you can definitely join to be a moderator for this channel. And make sure you guys join the Mafia email newsletter list, where I'm going to be sending you guys weekly newsletters of what I'm up to, and most importantly, when I post new videos. Not every single time is going to be weekly. I won't spam you guys, I promise. Make sure you guys peep the description box for every little bit of details that you guys always ask me about down in the comment section below. So yeah, let's get into it.
Here's a different side, loves school. She made the honor roll. She's on the track team. And she also smokes pot every single day.
With what? Money! Bruh, I remember when I was in high school, I had friends that literally would smoke. Well, they're not my friends. It was definitely not my friends. I knew people in high school that legitimately would smoke, drink, and do all types of craziness all day, every day. And I'm like, where did you get the money? Where did you get the fun? You ain't got no job. You ain't got no man. You ain't got no parents. 1 + 1 = 28. First of all, if you have a kid that's doing this stuff, clearly they have some sort of adult or some sort of something that's giving them this, right? So the logic here has to be a person that's older that's giving them this. So find the person and press the motherfucking charges. And the fact that she think that just because she loves school and she doing all of this goofy shit that she can do what she want, that's another toxic problem. I see a lot of parents be doing that goofy shit when they be like,
oh, well, if you do this, then you can do that.
That's part of that behavior. Stop doing that, because that can turn into this.
Has quite a temper because one night Sai tried to beat up one of Ramadu's friends. Ramadu gets arrested for
all. Nah.
I'm one of the best students in my school.
I
also earned several medals for running track. Can somebody please tell my mother to stop running her mouth?
Who is she talking to? She is so far gone. I'm sorry. Is she only 14? So disrespectful, I tell you.
I smoke weed every day, just like all the kids my age. It's not like I'm 11 or 12, I'm 14 years old.
As if she grow. It's not like I'm 11 or 12. I'm 14 years old, girl. You might as well just say you was 5. Hey, yo, get the Pampers for me. What the fuck, bitch? You might as well be in a diaper, you childish ass. Girl, you're not grown. You're very, very young. You're still a baby, bro.
I even beat up my mom's friend because she woke me up on a school night. I punched that hoe 10 times in her face, and that felt good.
Beyond Scared Straight needs to come back to television, because I genuinely do not understand what's going on here.
I'm doing my own thing and I don't need anybody to get in my way.
Wow.
Ever since we moved to DC, it's a lot of drugs, a lot of bad things going on, a lot of killing. She has a great big temper.
Be careful where you move your kids. It's actually very, very important. People be thinking that, you know, oh, it doesn't matter where I move, as long as I have my kid around good influences and they go to church and, you know, I keep them in a good school district, I'll be fine. No, where you move is a very, very strong influence on your kids and how they will, you know, be. Don't just think that if, you know, you keep them around you or whatever the case may be, that it's enough. I guarantee you, it's not enough. It's very, very important.
She got suspended from school for fighting?
Oh, yes.
Honor roll student. Apparently, she sent a nude picture of herself to another girl's boyfriend.
The girl got upset. She posted the new picture on Instagram. And that's why she got suspended.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't you ever send nude pictures to anyone, anywhere, ever. But if you ever gonna send a new photo, no face, no cake. People are petty. People are shiesty. You can't trust no man, but you definitely can't trust no bitch, because as you could hear what happened. And what's even worse is these things never, ever disappear. I had an ex that really tried to sit here and threaten me. Just don't do it, especially if you're as young as this. This is like really, really bad.
Just because she makes good grades, it's like, she, oh, mommy, I do what I'm supposed to
do
in school.
She thinks good grades are a pass.
She has called me a bitch before. She says I'm fat, ugly.
This audience is extra.
She had sex?
Yeah, she has. But she's on birth control.
Do you think that's problematic? I've heard a lot of people have different opinions about this. If you know that your teen is out of control or like having sex already and you clearly don't want them to, do you think it's a problem to go out and like put them on birth control? Or do you think that that, you know, helps solve the problem of them getting pregnant or whatever the case may be? Comment down below. I have no idea what I would do in that situation. I don't know. Personally, I have no answer for it. But let me know your thoughts and opinions down below. I am very, very, very curious to see what you guys have to say about that.
She can't keep smoking weed and run track. Everybody, 14-year-old Sai, here she is.
Is she 14? I'm 12. What the 14? No, that girl look grown. Wait.
Good as you are in school, what the heck is wrong with you?
It's never wrong with me. I just don't like when people tell me what to do. I'm gonna just do me at the end of the day.
Now, she look like she be smoking. Like, she look high. She look like she smoke.
I'm gonna say, I don't care. And I'm
gonna
still do me.
Is that a tat? Bro, the girl is grown. She's grown, like she's grown. The smirk on her face. Like, the crazy part is I literally went to high school with girls like this. And now looking back, I'm like, wow, I went to school with like a million girls like this. Shit, I fought girls like this, literally.
And you can do that because you get good grades, right?
Yeah, but I'm still gonna smoke weed tomorrow, the day after that, the day after that, the day after that.
My hometown has bad neighborhoods and you're messing around in the bad neighborhood.
It don't matter.
She's not taking any of this seriously. I personally can't figure out what the girl's problem is. This might just be a phase. I don't know why the hell she acting out like this. This is really, really bad. It's just gonna take the right one, the right time, the right situation to knock her ass right back into place. She's not the worst I've seen on this show. Y'all know, if y'all watch Maury, there's been some horrible kids. She's definitely not the worst I've seen, but she's not the best. The behavior is actually kind of scary to watch because she doesn't have any remorse. She doesn't care about the audience coming at her. She doesn't care about her mom's concerns. She's just very, very callous.
You love your mother?
Yeah, I love my mother.
Well, then why would you call her all those names?
It's for your own good, though.
I know, it's good.
Yeah,
I get the grace.
Smoking weed and all that stuff, you need to slow that down.
Good read on this girl. Maybe she's just bored. Maybe she just feels like her mom is not there enough. I don't know if she said anything about her father. Maybe I wasn't paying attention. I don't know if this is like a single mom household type of situation, but like maybe she just feels like she's being neglected in a sense. Maybe her mom works a lot. Maybe she just feels like she's not getting enough attention, so that's why she's running around with these badass kids. Maybe that's why, you know, she feels like she has to do all of this extra shit to get more attention, even if it's the wrong type of attention, because I'm just confused as hell right now. Her mouth is just incredibly horrible. Oh.
Do I run track? I did basketball. I was in the, I think the debate team. I was doing all of that.
You're on the debate team?
Yes.
Wow.
I don't understand why you do this other stuff. Then.
Because I want to do it. I mean, it don't matter. I mean, if I'm getting grades, it don't matter. I'm still going to do it. And y'all can't stop me from doing it.
These parts be annoying the hell out of me because it's like, it always makes me think the show is fake. Comment down below. I don't know. I feel like these shows are actually real. I feel like the other ones are like either faked or coerced in some way, but comment down below.
You're so full of potential. That pain that's inside of you, that's one of your greatest gifts. Because that gives you fire. You're a survivor, but you're fighting for the wrong things. Fight for your future. You've been overcoming things your whole life. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take you down to the open shelter.
When did you have any little talkers come speak to them? I'll just be like, a lot of these kids are actually going through real life problems that has a lot to do with their environment, their family, situational issues. Like, a pep talk not gonna do shit for them. I used to be one of these kids with a really bad attitude problem, not to this extent, but like, I used to have like a really bad attitude problem. If somebody would've came in my face yelling at me like this, I probably would've popped on him. This would not have helped me.
Our special guest, Bianca, Sai, and Heaven, straight to the open door shelter in Norwalk.
This is good. That's
what
I like.
Give in order to receive. The shelter's mission is to provide food and housing for families in need.
You feel good?
able to help people.
Right, right. Feels good to give, right?
Give back.
Right.
I really hope that this girl really got the help that she needed and that she actually went back home and she took what she learned at this little reform camp for like a day. But I can honestly say I do not think any of those things really work long term, honestly, only because realistically it's only one day. When you're going to take a kid like that for one day or maybe even two and like expect them to change overnight, it's just not gonna work. Because one, they're going back to the same environment with the same ancient motherfuckers that they was with, and two, they're not going to be with the people that they were with that kind of scared them straight for a day, and three, a lot of them just don't give a shit. And a lot of them are not going to be influenced in a day. Let's be real, okay? This ain't like, it has to be pretty drastic. Okay, let's be real. Kids are assholes and they're not gonna take something like that seriously. Like, come on now, community service for a fucking day and throwing a motivational speech in their face is not gonna do anything. You kinda need to do something for like a month. Something for a day is not gonna really do anything. So honestly, I don't know, she learned. I don't know if someone has like a little update they can give me or send me. Maybe she did. Maybe she didn't. Let me know if you had a kid like that. What would you do? I have no idea what I would do. She looked like a lost cause. I'd probably have to do it the old traditional Haitian route and just throw her ass to Haiti and call it a day. It's like, nah, I don't believe in sending your kids to Haiti. I feel like that's a horrible thing to do. Haitian parents love to do that shit, and I feel like it's very, very counterproductive and does nothing. I don't know any kid that's been sent to Haiti that has come back to America better. All of them come back worse. With that being said, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe. Make sure you guys peep the description box for more information. Join the newsletter. Do all that. And I'ma see y'all next time. Bye!